Welcome students to Thakur Vidya Mandir High School and Junior College. Today we are going to start with part 5 of chapter number 7, Bill of Exchange. Now here students, already we have done case 1 in our previous slide, and in that the written bill was there, the written bill's honor on the due date, and after that we did here the written bill dishonor. Now that was the case number 1. Now today we are going to start with case number 2, that is called what here, discounting the bill of exchange. Now let us understand here what is mean by the discounting of bill of exchange. Here a bill is drawn for a particular term and the drawee pays the amount of the bill on the due date. It means the bill is drawn by the drawer and as per the term, drawee is going to do the payment of the bill. Now here, drawer can obtain payment from bank before its due date by discounting the bill. Now, what does it mean here? Drawer can obtain payment from bank. It means, for an example, if the drawer he has drawn the bill for 2 months period, but drawer he is in need of money, in that case, drawer, he will just go to the bank and he is going to just sell this bill to the bank. And therefore, in the bracket, I have mentioned here selling the bill to the bank. So discounting here, it means discounting the bill means what he is selling the bill to the bank. Therefore, drawer can obtain payment from bank before its due date by discounting the bill. Here, now see here, bank deducts certain amount of bill for the services rendered, which is known as discounting charges. Now, what does it mean here? Now, in this case, when the drawer he is selling the bill to the bank before the due date, bank is giving this facility to the current account holder, that is to the drawer. And in this case, bank is going to take certain charges because drawer he is getting the payment before the due date, right? So this is called what your discounting charges. Now in this case, see here, the ownership transferred from drawer to bank. It means now, as the drawer is going to sell the bill to the bank, the ownership is transferred from drawer to the bank. Now owner is bank. Now here, discounting being an expenses for drawer is debited in his book of accounts. It means here, bank, he is going to deduct certain amount, right here, that is called what a discounting of bill of exchange, discounting charges, and this discounting charges, it is an expenses for the drawer's point of view, right? So here, the second case, discounting the bill of exchange. In short, it means the ownership transfer from drawer to the bank and bank is making the payment to the drawer before the due date. Now, let us see here the journal entry of case number 2. Now, see here in the books of drawer and in the books of drawee. Now, goods sold on credit basis. I am going to just explain you once again the entire transaction. It means if your sum is going to be given like this, goods sold, bill drawn, bill discounted, so that you will come to know the entire entry related with case number 2. So when the goods sold on credit basis, in drawer's book, debtor's account debited to sales account and being goods sold on credit, and in drawer's book, he has purchased the goods and therefore purchase account debit to creditor's account. So this is the entry of sales and purchase in drawer's and drawer's book. Second here, now after selling the bill or after selling the goods on credit basis, drawer, he is going to draw the bill and therefore drawer draws the bill and acceptance receipt. See the journal entry here. Bills receivable account debit to drawer's account. Bill is drawn and accepted and therefore he is going to receive the bill and therefore bills receivable account debited to drawer's account. Drawer is the keeper. And narration here, being bill drawn and acceptance received. Now, in the books of here, drawer's account debit to bills payable, because bills payable, it is a liability, and therefore, drawer's account debited to bills payable account, bill acceptance given. So, in this case, drawee accepted and he has returned the bill to the drawer. Now, let us see here the next. Now, drawer discount the bill with the bank. Now, see here, this is the entry number 3. Now here, drawer, he is in need of money and that is the reason he is selling the bill to the bank. Now see the journal entry. Here, he is going to sell the bill and therefore drawer's bank account, current bank account is a receiver and therefore bank account debit. Discount account debit to bills receivable account. Here students, discount account debit, the amount that the bank is going to be deduct from his bill, that is called what a discount, and it is expenses for the drawer's point of view and therefore it is debited over here. Discount account debit to bills receivable. To bills receivable means what your ownership is transferred now. Now the bank is going to become the owner of the bill. And therefore the narration that we have written here, being drawee's acceptance discounted with the bank. Now let us see here in the books of drawee. Now see here, there will be no entry because drawee is not a party to the transaction. Here, no entry in the books of drawee because it is none of the business of the drawee. Only his job is what he has to do the payment of the bill on the due date. Therefore, no entry in the books of drawee. Now, see the next year. Now, discounted bill honored on due date. It means here, now after the completing the period of 2 months or whatever the period that is mentioned here, drawee is going to do the payment of the bill. Now, let us see here journal entry over here. Now, see here students. There will be no entry because drawer has already received the cash. As I said, the ownership is transferred because bank has done the payment to the drawer right here before the due date. Therefore, on the due date, drawer is not going to receive any money. The money is going to be paid to the bank by the drawee. And therefore, in the drawee's book, bills payable account debited to cash or bank account because drawee has to do the payment of the bill on the due date and therefore he is going to pass a simple journal entry, that is bills payable to cash or bank. So here students, in this case we have seen here, when the discounted bill is honored on due date, there will be no entry in the books of drawer. Right? Now let us see here the next. Now, discounted bill dishonored on the due date. Now, this bill which was discounted with the bank, it is dishonored. Now what does it mean? After completing the particular period of bill, drawee opposed to the drawer and he is saying he is unable to do the payment of the bill. And that is called what here? Bill is dishonored. And this bill is here discounted and therefore discounted bill dishonored. Let us see here the journal entry. Here, drawee's account debited to bank account. Because drawee is again going to become debtor and therefore he is going to be debited and bank is the giver of the bill and therefore to bank account. Now in the books of drawee here, bills payable account debited to drawer's account. Because again here bills payable is going to be transferred expenses from the drawee's point of view. Therefore bills payable account debited to drawer's account. Here bills payable to drawer's account. Being our acceptance dishonored on due date. Now, see here the next. Now, discounted bill dishonored and noting charges paid by bank. Here, the noting charges, it is going to be paid by the bank. It is going to be given in the sum very clearly. So, what addition that we have to do in dishonored entry? Let us see here the difference. Here, see. Entry is going to be remain same here, drawee's account debited to bank account. But what are the changes that we have to do in the amount? See here, in the narration part, being discounted bill dishonored on the due date and noting charges paid by bank is equal to amount of bill plus noting charges. So in this case, we are going to add the amount of noting charges in the amount of 40th bill. Therefore, we have to remember whenever discounted bill is dishonored, noting charges amount we are going to add in this along with the amount of the bill. And now see here in the books of drawee. Yeah. In his book, the entry is going to remain same as we have done in case number 1. That is bills payable account debit, noting charges account debit to drawer's account. Because he has to pay noting charges to the drawer. And therefore, being our acceptance, dishonor and noting charges payable. That is, he is going to do the payment of noting charges in future date. So here, students, we have done here the second case, that is bill discounted with the bank and when bill is honored on due date and when the discounted bill is dishonored on due date. Please go through all the journal entries of case number 1 and case number 2. And after that, we are going to start with here case number 3 and case number 4. Please learn thoroughly all journal entries. Without this, it is not possible to solve the sum. I hope that you people have understood this. Thank you, students. Thank you very much.